Hi friends, let me begin this session with a story about a king who was very just and generous. His kingdom was self-sufficient and his people were very happy. In a particular year, there was abundance in the production of mangoes and apples, which led to chaos among the people for selling and buying the fruits. Some people were selling them at a lower price at some places and some others at a higher price. Injustice was happening as there was no fixed pattern of the price. So the king called a meeting with his ministers and came out with following conclusion. As there were two markets in the kingdom, two sets of different prices were kept. For the first market, the condition was, a person willing to sell his products in this market can set any price for the individual fruits, such that the price of one mango and one apple should total up to 4 rupees. That means, if M is the price of a mango and small letter A is the price of an apple, then M plus A should be equal to 4. Keeping this criterion in mind, 4 sellers put their shop in the first market and the prices were displayed as it was not a compulsion for the sellers to always sell the fruits in pairs. One can sell individual fruit at their individual prices, but the pricing should satisfy the criteria. Taking the example of shop A, how much money will I have to pay if I buy 4 apples? Yes, you are right, it's 12 rupees. And what if I have to buy 2 mangoes and 3 apples? Then I will have to pay 11 rupees, right? Likewise, it would be same for the other shops. Mathematically, if you see, many more such shops could be set with different combinations of prices. We have just considered the above 4 examples. For the second market, one will have to follow a little different rule. For the second market, the criteria was, a person willing to sell his products in this market can set any price for the individual fruit such that the price of 2 mangoes and 1 apple should total up to 6 rupees. So we can write it as 2m plus a equal to 6. The prices once set cannot be changed to avoid duplication. And so no single individual can sell his products in both the markets by changing the price. Any individual not following the said rules will be punished. Individuals had the freedom to choose the market whichever was favorable to them. But one day, the king was informed that there is a man who is selling his product in both the markets. He was presented before the king. On questioning, he said that he is following the criteria of both the markets. That means he was selling his products without changing the price of individual fruits. Everyone was surprised. King asked, "How is that possible?" He explained that there was only one way by which he could fix his price for individual fruits for both the markets without breaking the rules. He drew 2 columns as shown below and said, "As we all can see, there is only one place in the table where the prices for individual fruits are same. And that also fits the criteria. So I am selling the fruits without changing the price." Friends, this man seemed very sound from his mathematical concepts. And he also knew how to relate it with a real-life situation. He presented this scenario before the ministers algebraically as well as graphically and said, "The solution which we get is the unique solution." Are you getting it? After hearing to the man, the king was happy to know that there is someone who will help him to set an unbreakable rule. King gave him another pair of combination and asked to find the loophole. The earlier equation 2m plus a equal to 6 was little modified as 2m plus 2a equal to 8, and the second equation remained as it is. That person started plotting some points and lines on the paper and showed to the king, as both lines were overlapping, and said, "Your Majesty, this equation would give you the same line when you take the number 2 common. Here, whatever price you fix for the equation m plus a equal to 4 will remain same for 2m plus 2a equal to 8. You can try it for any combination. And that was true. Finally, that person suggested that if we keep the price for the first market as M plus A equal to 4 and that for the second market as M plus A equal to 6, then there won't be any replication in the prices. He also showed it graphically that lines were parallel and parallel lines never intersect. So it will not have any common point. Friends, by now even we have understood how this situation can be related to a mathematical concept called a pair of linear equations in two variables. He gave a chart to the king and said, it will help you whenever you are stuck in any such situations. This chart explains that the general form of a linear equation in two variables is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So for two linear equations, we can write it as a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. And now, if we want to check whether the lines are intersecting, parallel or overlapping. So what we'll do, we'll take the ratios of the coefficients of x and y respectively, as well as the ratios of the constant of the two linear equations. So we will get a1 upon a2, b1 upon b2 and c1 upon c2. Okay? So if the first two ratios, that is a1 by a2 and b1 by b2, not equal, that means the lines are intersecting and it will have only one solution, that is unique solution. And if these two ratios are equal, then we'll check for the third ratio, that is the ratio of c1 by c2. If all three ratios are equal, then the lines are overlapping, that means coincide, and it will have many solutions. And if the first two ratios are not equal to the third ratio, then the lines are parallel and it will have no solution. Friends, these are the conditions to check whether lines are intersecting, overlapping or parallel. And these conditions are called conditions for consistency. It means whenever solutions exist, whether it is unique or many, equations are said to be consistent. And it will be inconsistent only if there does not exist any solutions. Means only in the case of parallel lines. Okay? It was because of his interest in mathematics that he could relate it to a real life situation. King was very happy that such a clever person lives to his town. He rewarded him with the prize and took him as his financial advisor. To know from where and how he made that chart, meet in the next session. Till then, why don't you try and find a loophole for this scenario?
I hope you like our video. You can also buy our courses in the form of DVDs, pen drives and online courses, which are available on different platforms. All links are given in the description box below. Press that bell icon and turn your notifications on. And also, please do not forget to like, comment, share and subscribe.